All right, so we are back, and in the previous video, we added some simple collision spheres around our character's hands so that we can interact with our environment when we punch. So we can punch things and knock them around that are physics objects, which is pretty fun. In this video is a little bit of an extra credit project. We've kind of already worked with animation Notifies, but I wanted to work with them again to kind of show you how you can create a particle effect while the character is running around to kick up some dust. You could also use this as a way to cue sound effects for like footsteps when the character is walking, etc. So I kind of wanted to take this video to take a stab at doing that. So let's continue inside of our project here. Let's hop down to the content browser, make sure that you are under the character and animations folder, and let's go to the third person run animation sequence. So go ahead and double click and open that up. To open it up in Persona. Again, we are on the animation tab of Persona. This is where we will be doing our notifies in this window here in the center. So what we wanna do, if I'm gonna pause playback here really quickly, and let's move our character so we can get a better view of him. What we wanna do is add a notify essentially when our character's foot hits the ground. So somewhere around there, we will add a notify event to play a particle effect. And we'll do the same thing when his other foot hits the ground as well. And it's pretty easy to do inside Persona here. So all we need to do, let's drag this timeline here somewhere to around, I would say, the seventh frame, something like this. Looks like his foot's going to hit the ground right about there. And then up in this notify section up here, we can right click and choose add notify. Now, we have some other options in here. We have is punching one and two. We created that in a previous video. And we also use the new notify. But at the very top, we have play particle effect and play sound, which are pretty standard if you just want to play a sound or a particle effect as a notify event. So go ahead and select the play particle effect. And that's going to add it. And if we click on it now, inside the details panel, you'll see we have the opportunity to define what the particle effect is going to be. That we can do that inside the drop down here. Now, because we included starter content with this project, we have some particle systems to play with. So we're going to start out just to make sure that we get things working by using this P_explosion. So go ahead and select that from that drop down. And there's one other option that I wanted to talk about really quickly. There's this attached option. And you can see the option, the tooltip for it says should attach to the bone or socket. And essentially what this means is as we get to this event, you see that the particle effect plays. As we get to this event, we're going to continue moving in game. So if we leave this checked, what is actually going to happen is that this particle effect will follow us as we move around. So for right now, we're going to leave this checked to kind of illustrate that when we get into the editor and test this here in a moment. But let's add our other particle effect to the other foot. So go ahead and drag the timeline on a little bit more, somewhere around the 15th frame, 16th frame, somewhere around here. It looks like we're about the 16th frame. So go ahead and right click in the notify section again. Add notify and play particle effect. And click the particle effect. And then in the details panel in the upper right, assign a particle system to use. So click the drop down and P explosion. Now, what we're going to do, you see there's an option too as well. It says socket name. We can define where we want to attach this particle effect. And the socket name that we can reference. We can reference a bone name too, as it says here. We can use our skeleton tree to get the name of the bone that we want to attach it to. So for example, we want to attach it to the foot. So let's scroll down a little bit and let's find our feet inside of our skeleton tree here. Although it should be down near the bottom. There we go. So we have foot L, which is our left foot, and we have ball L. So if we look at foot L and go into the viewport here, kind of up at the ankle is where that is. But if we pick ball L, you can see it's at the kind of around the toes. I think that's a better place to attach it rather than at the ankle. So we're going to use ball L and ball R for our two sockets. So let's click on the first particle effect here. This should be our right foot, right? Yeah. So let's go ahead and use the ball_R for our bone name here. So we're just going to type in ball not caps, ball. And you can see it actually populates for you with relevant names from our skeleton. So go ahead and select ball underscore L, which it didn't work for some reason. That might be a new feature that hasn't been fully implemented yet. Hopefully by the time you're watching this, that has been addressed and you can select it from here. Didn't seem to catch. Let's try it again on the other particle effect. So let's select the other particle effect and we'll use ball underscore. Actually, this should be R. I'm glad I caught that. That should be R, not L for this one. So ball underscore R. And then on the other one, we're going to use ball underscore L. So let's try that again. Ball underscore L. I guess you have to make sure that it's highlighted. Yeah, you have to make sure that it's highlighted. So that is user error, not engine error there. So we have attached it to the socket. Technically, this will work for us right now. So we can actually save up here in the upper left and test it out. So let's hop back to the level editor here and let's play in the editor. Now, as we're running around, you should see, boom, we are running around and exploding feet. That looks pretty cool. And notice that they are attached to us. So let's try that again without attaching them to see what kind of effect we get. So let's hit escape and go back to our skeleton up here. And let's select the first particle effect there and uncheck attached. And do the same thing for the other particle effect as well. So there we go. And let's save again. And let's play and see what that looks like now. So now as we run around, it's still kind of attached to our feet a little bit, but you can see that the smoke follows us. We'll be able to demonstrate this a little bit better when we create our own particle system here really quickly. But you can see that there's a trail of smoke following now that we leave behind, which is cool. So with that, let's actually create our own particle system here. Now, a bit of a warning, I'm not going to go too in-depth into Cascade, which is the particle system editor inside Unreal Engine 4, because there's a lot involved in that. But I did want to create a particle system really quickly so that we can have a little bit better of an effect. If you'd like to learn about particle systems, you can go to our documentation under Unreal Engine or docs.unrealengine.com. It will take you to the main documentation page under Engine Features, Graphics. There's a whole section on particle systems and the ins and outs and key concepts, et cetera. Feel free to come here and read up on particle systems a little bit later if you'd like. So let's create our particle system. Now, again, it's going to be pretty basic. And since we're using starter content, there's really no need to reinvent the wheel. So we're going to borrow one of the existing particle systems. So down in the content browser under the starter content folder, let's make use of our starter content. Let's go to the particles folder. Let's go ahead and open that up. Now there's a bunch of different options in here that we could use. There's our P explosion that we're currently using, but we're gonna use this P underscore steam underscore lit. And we're gonna make some modifications to this. So right click on it and select duplicate from the context menu. Let's give this a new name. We're gonna call this P underscore dust, like so. And then go ahead and double click to open it up. Mine kind of popped off screen here, so I'm just going to bring that in so that we can see it. And I'm also going to maximize it because we're going to be inside here for a moment. So we are inside Cascade now, which is the particle editor inside Unreal Engine 4. And there's all kinds of different things in here that we could be talking about, but we're going to save that for another video series. We're kind of going to take this as a do as I'm doing type of learning session here. So let's continue. Let's make our basic particle system here. First thing we're going to do is make sure that we have nothing selected. Currently, this is where all of the emitters will be for our particle system. We only have the one, but we're going to make sure nothing is selected. So we're going to click off into this empty space here because we want to hop down to the details panel. We want to make a couple quick changes. So first of all, we have this warm-up time, the time for the particle system to warm up, as the name suggests here. It's currently set to 7. We're going to zero this out, actually. We want to make this 0 because we want 0 warm-up time. So go ahead and zero that out, hit enter. And the other changes that we want to make, we're going to hop up to the emitter itself and click the spawn module so that we make changes to how it spawns. First thing we're going to go to is our rate and distribution. Now, yours may not have been expanded. Go ahead and expand that this rate option and distribution. And then for constant, it's currently set to 2. Let's zero this out as well, like so. And then we also want to uncheck process spawn rate. Now our particle system is going to disappear in our viewport here, but we're going to make some changes to our burst because we want this particle effect to burst instead of just spawning in. So go ahead and click the plus sign next to the burst list option here. That's going to add an element for us and give us some settings to adjust. Currently the count is set to 0. We want to change this to something like, let's say 10. So 10 particles, just spawn in 10 particles like so. I think that's good. And then also we want to, let's scroll down, scroll up. I think we're done in here for the moment. I don't think we need to make any other changes in here. Let's go to the required module. So go ahead and click the required module. Here we go. First thing we're going to check is kill on completed. We want to destroy this emitter when it's done. So go ahead and check the kill on completed checkbox there. It'll continue spawning in here over and over again. This is just because this is the preview window. So that's why we're seeing that. And then also under the duration section, I think emitter duration is fine for 1 second. But let's scroll down a little bit and let's go to emitter loops. Let's go ahead and just change this to 1. It's currently set to 0. So it'll give us 1 puff of smoke and that's it. Let's hop up to our lifetime module now. So let's go over to the lifetime section here. So go ahead and click that. And let's expand lifetime and expand distribution. And the min-max is currently set to 5 and 7. That's pretty high. Let's go to about, 3 and 5. That's still kind of long. So let's actually bump that down a little bit more. Let's try 1 and 2. So it kind of just pops in and then pops out. So it's really short. That looks like a little bit of a cloud of smoke, but it's pretty big. We don't want that big of a dust effect. So, and also we want to change the color of it because it's currently kind of white. So let's change that. Let's go to our color over life section here, our color over life module. So go ahead and click that. We're going to expand the color over life, color distribution. The constants are currently set to 1, 1, and 1. Let's change these up. Let's change the green to, say, 0.7. So now it's purple. Let's change the blue to, 0.5. There we go. It's looking a little bit more like dirty, I guess the word I want to use here. Dusty. There we go. Let's hop down to the alpha over life so we can change some of the settings here as well. To change this, let's go over to the color over life module. Let's click this little curvy line over here. Go ahead and click this. That's going to add our color over life keyframes here that we can change. Let's try and grab. Is it this one we want? Let's see. Let's move that up just a little bit. No, we don't want that. That's not the one we want. Let's hold Control Z to get back. Let's use this one. I think this is the one that we want. Let's pull this down a little bit. Something like somewhere around here. Let's pull this one down just a little bit too. Something so it kind of evens out like so. So it's not as high coming in and kind of trails off. I think this is good enough. Again, you can kind of play with these curves however you'd like to get the effect that you want, but it's just going to come in and you're going to see it appear and then it's going to disappear over time really quickly. So we're also going to add some other effects to this. Actually, let's do that now. Drag is already here. So let's make some changes to drag. So let's expand the drag coefficient. Its constant is currently set to 0.8. Let's bump that up. Let's bump that to, say, 5. So there we go. That looks kind of cool. Not too bad. I think we do need to change our size still. So let's hop over to our initial velocity. So we're going to go to the initial velocity module and our start velocity. Let's change this and expand distribution. We're currently set to 3216. Let's try the max. Let's try 100 and 100. Leave the Z 50. We're currently kind of expanding upwards We want to go more outward, so we're going to make some changes here to do that. Let's change the min as well. That's why we're leaving the z at 50. Changing the x and y will expand it outward. So let's try for the min. Let's say negative 100 and negative 100. Like so. Something like that. I think that's good. We need to make one more change to our initial size now, our start size and distribution. And same with the max settings here. Let's change these. Let's try for the max 75. And for the min, let's try 50. There it is. It's a little bit tinier now. I think that's good. That's good enough for now. Let's try this out, actually. Let's save. And let's close this particle effect. Now, with the particle effect still selected here, and our skeleton tab still open, let's actually hop to our skeleton tab now. We're still in Persona. On the animation, you're on the animation tab. Click your particle effects now. And in the details panel for your particle effects, we can click this arrow because we're going to use the selected asset from the content browser, which is our dust effect there. So go ahead and click the arrow here. You should assign it. You can see, which it does. And let's do the same thing for the other one. Like so. And let's check that. See what that looks like. That looks a little bit better. Again, it's playing right there because we're not moving. But once we get in game, it should not be attached. And you'll see it kind of trailing behind the player character. So let's test that out. Let's actually play and see what it looks like. Let's play in the editor here. And let's run around. So there we go. Getting kicking up a little bit of dust there as we're running around. Obviously, it could be a little bit better, but kind of shows you how you can do it. And again, you can add sound effects to this for footsteps if you'd like using those notifies. But I think that's good. I think we can wrap here. What we've done is created a particle system and used animation notifies to play that particle system during certain points inside of our animation using Persona. That's going to wrap this video up. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for tuning in, and we will see you next time.